In the last video, I arrived in a small village in rural South Korea to spend a few days living and working with a family on their massive chestnut farm. In this video, we take a break from work on the farm and get dropped off in the closest town to explore a local Korean market.
I just love visiting markets. This is like a lively, bustling wet market.
We hope to get a glimpse into what a traditional market looks like in Korea and see whether we can meet some friendly locals.
Thank you!
Join me as we explore a rural Korean market town together and even get an unexpected invite from a local villager.
Chan! Hello, we are in Cheongyang, the main town of the area that we are currently staying in. Donggun, our host, dropped us off to look around the market that happens only once every 5 days.
Every day with a 2 or a 7 in it. So 2nd, 7th, 12th, 17th, 22nd, 27th.
Perhaps it's a lucky number, we don't know. But yeah, I'll be excited to actually see a bit more of what actually Korean diet looks like, what do they sell, and probably we'll find some interesting stuff.
Are walking from the very start of the market. Look at this many cabbage. This is what people use to cook kimchi, basically the essential. This is the essential diet to Korean dish. This is radish as well. These two always are available. I feel like I know very little about Korean dish apart from kimchi, which is the cabbage and radish.
I think this is like kimchi season. Like everyone makes kimchi these days from cabbage.
Yeah, probably. I think because throughout the winter, it would be like just a perfect season to marinate and ferment kimchi.
And make lots of soup.
Yeah.
Over here, you've got many different dried version of seafood. I think this is octopus. I think that's like many things that I don't know. This is probably fiddle fern. That's definitely anchovies. That's seaweed. There's dried ebi or small shrimp.
What do you think of it?
There's a lot of variety. You can tell they're very creative with their food here because there's just so much stuff.
We are entering, I think, the main section where this bit you've got quite a bit of different beans. Over here you've got like steam corn, steam other stuff. I was just like, hello. Oh, I was just showing a bit of this. I think this is like braised pork. Wow, Lucas.
Jokbal.
Chokpa. I think that's where they braise it.
Sauce.
Wow, look at that. It's very hot. It's very cute. He's just showing us around. I think what's funny is that some sellers are very much excited to be featured because obviously it... Ah, hot. Oh, oi, oi, oi. Which means delicious.
Congratulations.
So this is his shop. What are you selling here?
Yeah.
Beans. Peanuts. Yeah. Peanuts. This is pumpkin seed, walnut.
Cashew nut.
Oh, almonds. So many. It's got 1,000 won over here. It's so lovely because oftentimes we are a bit apprehensive in the way that we approach locals, and he was just so cute in showing us. thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. We've just been fed by the sellers here. That's nice peanut.
Very fresh.
Our hands are full.
Sunset.
Oh, thank you so much. Kamsahamnida. Name? Your name?
Name? B.Y.
B.Y. Oh, sounds like a cool rapper name. Kamsahamnida. He refused to be paid. See you later. I think it's just sweet because we don't know how the locals are about filming, but I think
they seem to be very happy,
excited to be promoted for their business, but also just welcoming lots of people today. I think what's interesting to me is the constant familiar vegetables that I've seen so far. Radish, cabbage, onion, spring onions are mostly the main staple for the Korean diet. It's like people would buy this many cabbage and radish for them to make kimchi at home. Look at this all of intricate roots. They're selling so many types of that. I think they use it to make alcohol out of it. It's so fascinating. The market just extends to every nooks and crannies of this area. This section seems like they specialize on selling seafood. Look at this many fish. I think that's a stingray. And over there you've got crab, some octopus. I just love visiting markets. This is like a lively, bustling wet market. I think even in a small town like this, market is essential, definitely, because unlike cities where people purchase their necessities out of supermarket, in a town like this, market plays an important role in trading goods, trading groceries and all of that. I'm just in an awe, just like observing here and there what they are selling, the type of diet, the type of fish that they are consuming, even some of the herbs, the roots that I've never seen. Fascinating. We heard music's playing around, thinking that there must be some off recording going on. Turns out it's just a live performance happening here. Oh, they're getting ready for another round. Let's see. When in Korea, karaoke is essential, so you dance around. We finished exploring the market. It was fun, but also I think it's a bit too cold.
Yeah, we're going to go and try and get the bus. It leaves in 10 minutes, so hopefully we'll get it.
And that's it. That's the last bus of the day. 안녕하세요. Do you speak English? A little bit. We are going to this Jakchonri. Do you know Jakchonri?
Okay.
We don't know which bus to go.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, you know.
Same bus.
Same bus, okay. So can we go with you together?
Yeah.
Okay. So we are in some sort of bus station, but I think we don't quite know which numbers to get. Oh, okay, this way. Yeah. Oh, this one.
Yeah, yeah. Oscar, where are you going?
Oh, okay.
So I think I can pay by cash.
Two?
Ah, kamsahamnida.
I was quite nervous. I was like, oh, did we miss it? Where are we? So we came home and found Dongun's mom hanging out with one of her neighbors, and her neighbor was like, do you want to come home with us? I was like, yeah, sure. So she's stealing us from the family. Then we'll just see you around a bit more. Thank you. We're in a car. I mean, it's just truly a random, unexpected interactions, and I think we just want to embrace this type of travel a lot more, even though we don't know what's going to happen. So the lady has been driving around delivering this soup that she makes, and then she just put that in a paper bag and then knock on several doors and just deliver them as a kind gesture. How sweet! Oh my goodness. Such a beautiful garden. Come in? Oh, okay. This way.
Welcome to my house.
Oh, thank you. Isn't she the sweetest? Indonesia.
Indonesia.
England. Yongguk. Yongguk. Indonesia. So pretty.
Are you hungry?
Hungry?
Like
a little bit. Okay, okay.
Oh, you see. We are
drinking.
Drinking.
Yeah. Tea. Yes.
First,
yes.
And then?
And eat a little bit. Yeah. Oh, perfect. Thank you. What is this? Oh, sweet. Oh my goodness, so random. And yeah. She's just, I think she just likes doing nice things to other people, you know. Oh, just so nice.
So sweet.
I made it.
Oh, wow.
Keep
okay.
The snake.
Okay.
Very tasty.
Yeah. Mmm.
Mmm. Hot.
Really nice. Mashiseo. I don't know what the flavor is, quite easy. A kind of slightly sticky texture.
Yeah, very yum.
Yummy.
Very good snack. Yeah, I will have one more. So interesting. So you've got this sesame seed around it, and it's like sort of caramelized.
How posh do I feel? We are, I think, going to see the tea ceremony that she's going to perform. It's so intricate and detailed because I think you've got so many different steps.
I like tea very much.
Yeah, I also like tea very much.
Every day.
Mm. Oh, lovely. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow, look at that.
Is this tea from Korea? Or
oh,
from
Korea. In Beiruji. Thank you.
So I think we were told that there's a ritual to this. This reminds me of tea drinking culture in China as well, when I used to live in China. But she said that we first need to look at it in terms of appreciation and stuff like that. And I suppose the second step would be to sniff. And the third, yeah, drink it. It's very light. It's so very meditative to see her doing the tea ritual and also just like drinking it. Chicken.
Chicken and
tteokbokki.
Tteokbokki,
yeah. How do you say a cheese in Chan? Chan.
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 Chan. Chan.
Chan.
Chan.
Chan.
Chan.
Chan.
No,
like
enough.
Chan.
Chan. Okay.
Chan.
You're smart.
Oh!
I'm smart.
Chan.
Chan. Five-star hotel.
Yeah.
Five-star hotel.
Seven-star.
We will go seven-star, yes. We are saying goodbye to the house and to our host lady that has been so kind. Thank you so much. Come so
right?
Turn right.
Okay,
yes.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
I'll give you a hug.
Oh, thank you.
See you again. Very nice to meet you. Bye bye. Jagu. Lovely.
We're just getting out with the family. Can't wait to see what the activity for tomorrow's will be like. So yeah, see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like and comment below and follow my Instagram if you don't already. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications to not miss the last video from this series, where we are back working on the farm and help make the biggest batch of kimchi I've ever seen in my life. See you again next time. Bye!